Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1832. Bob Umlas, put in totals with VBA, even though it's chaotic data. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today I have something special. I have a guest post from Bob Umlas. Bob is the author of this great book, Excel Outside the Box, Unbelievable Excel Techniques. There are 54 amazing techniques in this book. I'm going to put the link where you can buy the book right down there in the YouTube comments. So check it out. All right, Bob.
Hi, this is Bob Umlas talking to you from the summit in good old Washington State. All right, here's a worksheet, very simple. Supposing all you want to do is put in subtotals. You want a subtotal, I mean a total here in cell C4, and a total here, and a total here. And I'm going to do it in VBA, and let's just say this goes on and on. The solution is already done in this button, but I want to show you a couple of things about it. One, you might think that this is a little complicated because in this case, it looks like we have two blank lines, and then here we have three blank lines, and this most of them are three columns, but this one is four columns. So it looks like you'd have to really analyze the data. But in fact, aside from the sub and end sub and the for next loop, this is done in one statement. And it's also quite instant. You see it's done already. I want you to just notice something here, that what this data is, and I'm going to undo all these. So we put it back to the way it was originally. These are all the formulas. So when I, if I branch to special, and I go to all the constants, not just numbers with text, but all the constants, you'll notice that there are like four pieces or four chunks of things. And if, as long as you know your data is in pieces, you can work with each piece at a time. So each piece has a certain number of columns and rows. And if I use, I'm actually using the word chunk in the macro. So for each chunk in each one of these areas, each, we have four areas here, we can know the number of columns in the area or in the chunk and the number of rows in the chunk. And that's makes it able to be done all in one statement. So let's look at assign macro, and I'll edit this PIT, which stands for put in totals. And here's the total. So sub put in totals for each chunk, and the chunk is each one of those areas, in the cells dot special cells, all the constants, because there were no formulas in there. And the key thing here is that each one is an area. So each chunk as it goes through is one of these areas. So that area or chunk offset by the number of rows in that chunk, chunk.rows.count, and then offset by the number of columns in that in the chunk, also minus one, and minus one because of using the offset. And I'm resizing that whole thing one by one, and we'll take a look at what that is in the background. But that formula is, and we'll go back to this in a moment, the sum of the row that I'm in and the chunk's row, and the column that I'm in through the row above where I'm at. So let's take a look at the first chunk, which is A1 through C3. So chunk.rows.count is 3. Chunk.columns.count is 3. So this is 3 minus 1. I'm sorry, 3, 3, 2. Chunk.offset 3, 2. This is the chunk. Offset by 3 is 1, 2, 3 down here. 1, 2, 3. And offset by three columns, 1, 2, 3, but the minus one takes you here. So that's the cell I'm in. Currently it has the same shape though. It's still a 3x3 shape. That's why I say resize one by one. And that formula is the cell that I'm in, the column that I'm in, the chunk dot row is row one, and through the row that I'm in, above the row I'm in. So you can see that each one of these, this is the sum of C1 through C3, which is the row above, D6 through D9, and so on. It works pretty cool.
All right, there you go. Now, Bob has been a Microsoft Excel MVP longer than any MVP. He was there when the program started. Great way to simplify that task. The book has more than just VBA, though, and we'll have more podcasts from Bob over the coming weeks. So check it out. Again, the link right down there in the YouTube comments. Well, thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.